Brother, what happened to Karen? I don't know what to say. Why was she even at the mall? Out of all the stores, why was she right next to the bomb? I'm just trying to understand. Do you know anything?
This is not a good time.
It's okay. I understand. Sorry.
No, I don't think you understand at all. You don't even have a glimpse of how it feels when the one you love is wounded in a senseless attack. I can't even be there for her. Yet here we are, feign concern and immediately question what I know. Why? Ah, I see. You must have read it too. That I called her right before the incident.
Herban.
It is true. I called moments before. What does that mean to you, dear brother? She was there against my advice, to track down this impertinent army woman. Karen wouldn't listen. She just pressed on and ignored me. She suffered the consequences because of...
How can you say that? She suffered the consequences of not listening to you, her wise and all-knowing husband.
What did you say?
How dare she defy the great Raban Vart? She was there, helping her patient, and you have no compassion. You are more concerned about being...
How do you dare say that? She is my wife.
Well, how dare you try to blame her for getting mixed up in all of this?
You insolent pest.
You have done nothing but snub me ever since we left the encampment. I've had it with this crap. For the record, if you hadn't kicked me out of TPV, I'd quit.
Go then, finally. You never cared for our cause anyway.
Thank you.
My dear followers, those of you who still remain, the story that has finally been spread by the despicable government mouthpiece, it is true. All of it. I never saved those children. Because I was too afraid. Because I ran for my life, eager of saving it before theirs. Here I now am. Alive. And they aren't. I had so long forgotten about it. And now it's shaking me to my core. I believed that if I only tried hard enough, I could change things. That I could make things better for my people at home in Barges. I believed I could fight against the corrupt, evil, rotten politicians longing for power at the people's expense. I believed I could free my home country from these parasites and go back home. If only I twisted words long enough. We all need a reliable base on which our world is based. Our truth. This was mine. But now I realize that I've been living a lie. Not only a lie that made you believe in me, but a lie that allowed me to forget who I actually was. A far too comfortable lie. Only one thing is worse. Knowing that even as I speak, you all continue. Carry on, fight on with all your fury, perpetuating that very lie endlessly, creating new truths based on fake claims put out there ages ago. What will become of this world when everybody has their own truth? What will be real, dependable? Everything will be nothing. Truth is dead. And I killed it that very day. I was too afraid to speak up and correct a mistake. But no longer. This story has to end on my terms. There's hardly anything more concrete than a bullet. It creates a tangible, uncomfortable fact. The very thing needed for a resurrection of truth. Thank you.